Another option, if the chart doesn't make sense, is to move the series order around. So for example, here I've got some data and I've got the end of phases. So I know the setup takes, say, 7 months. Print and distribution will end in month 17. So as we've shown here, it's 7 months of setup, then 10 months of distribution, print and distribution, to show a net figure. When I create it, however, so I'm going to go insert, I'm going to use a bar, choose that one. It's not quite what I want. I want different colors, so maybe I'll switch row and columns, so I get that. So that's pretty much what I want, but I do want them to be on top of each other. I don't want it like this. So I'm going to right click and say format data series, and I'll fully overlap them. The problem when I do that is now this one is covering all the others. I'm just going to add a legend in so we can actually see what we're doing. So you can see the establishing relationships over here is at the very top, so all the other stuff is hidden underneath. Instead of now going and changing the order or doing anything like that, what you can do, right click on the chart, say select data, and you'll see that the setup is as follows. And the way Excel works is that one is basically the first one drawn, then this one, then this one, then this one, and this is the last one, and it overlaps everything. So what we can do is I'm going to click on setup. You'll see we've got arrows, and I'm going to move that one to the bottom. You'll see now we see that. So that's the last one to be drawn. If I click here, I'm going to move it down 2. Click here, move it down 1. When I say OK, without changing the data, I can now see the three components. So all we've told Excel is which is drawn first, which is drawn last, and if you get the order right, you'll be able to see all the various components.